Hey Emily, what's up? Welcome back to another video. Today we're back, and today we are doing rating my merch collection. I have a lot, as you can tell by the big pile of clothes here. Yeah, I had an issue for a while that I always had to have something coming in the mail. I still kind of have this issue to an extent, but I've gotten a lot better with like not buying things I don't actually need. Until you watch my next video, and then you'll see that no, I still have that issue. I haven't bought merch in a really long time. So yeah, I guess we'll start with where like the first set of merch I got, which was Tanner Brungart's line of merch, which I have this shirt, the clickbait one, which okay, like if it didn't have clickbait on the back, I think I would wear it a lot more, but I think I'm gonna wear it more around the house this summer, I'm trying to. That's one thing I'm trying to be mindful of, is actually wearing all the clothes that I have, because there's no point in having clothes and then not wearing them. Oh, and also I did want to say thank you to everyone that's ever subscribed to me or watched my videos. It is so very appreciated. I started this channel just so my cousin can watch my videos, which I don't even think she watches anymore, but I enjoy doing it, so that's why I do it now. But thank you to everyone that subscribed. Like, I'm so close to 100 subscribers, which I would have never thought would have happened. It's actually crazy. So just thank you for all of the support, I guess. It is very much appreciated. It's just very much appreciated. So thank you to everybody that's ever interacted with my channel. The next one we have is this one, the Tan Clan one. I actually really like the shirt. I feel like it'd be nicer if it didn't have the big writing in the front, but I don't know why I bought it, but whatever. We bought it. So yeah, I don't know if it's in this big pile. And when I'm editing, if I don't have it, I will add a picture of this one. The shirt I still actually wear. Don't worry, I found it. This is me editing, by the way. It's this shirt. I love this one. I don't think I'll stop wearing that one ever. I went to Wonderland. It's the Rack shirt, which was the one that was the least anticipated one for this like group of shirts that I bought, and it ended up being my favorite, so I'm happy. I think because that one like looks less like merch than most shirts. Speaking of merch, that looks way too much like merch. I don't know why I got this one. It's Peyton Moore Myers, and I really like the tie-dye on it. I just don't like how it says Peyton on it, because like everyone's like, who's that? And it's like, I really gotta go really in detail about like the weird obsession with a TikTok guy. Like, yeah, this is just a really embarrassing video on my part. But the other one that I got with this was this shirt, which I really like this one. I wore it a lot in 2021 when I used to use my trampoline all the time. I would have it up and be using it now. However, we have a pool, so I don't have room for my trampoline. So when I move out, I will be able to use it again, but until then, I can't. And now I'm realizing I forgot two sweaters, so I'm gonna go grab those. Honestly, looking at these right now, I don't understand why I don't wear them as often, like, other than the whole Peyton thing, if I'm just like going out or like whatever. I adore these sweaters. I love the roses down the side. I love the writing, the rose. I think it's really nice, and it was a very comfy sweater. And I think it just looks really good. So I got this one in white, and then I also got it in black. And I think it looks good either way, but I think, I don't even know. I think the black better? I don't know. Maybe the, I don't know. I think they both look really good, which is probably why I got both. But yeah, I don't know why I don't wear these more. Hopefully I hold myself to this. Next winter, I will wear these more. Hopefully. I said dibs ones, because I still wear this. I love this one. I love the way it fits me. Even when I first got it, it's actually kind of crazy, because you can really see like the evolution of my muscles, because like I put this on now, I look jacked. When I had it on before, I was just like a little kid, little tiny, but that's okay. Not like I wasn't really working out, so. But I love this shirt. I still do, and I still wear it, and this is one of the sets of clothes that I'm not, like, I don't regret getting. I really like this shirt. We'll keep the dip stuff going. This is another one, which is a thing of merch that you can't tell is merch, which I love. This was like Tanner Brungert's like clothing line he had, and then it closed down. And I bought all this stuff whenever it was closing, so it was pretty cheap. This one I really like, except there's a hole in it because I forget what dog, one of the dogs I watched bit a hole in it. Which kind of sucks, but I still wear it. No one really notices, so it's like lower down, so it doesn't really affect anything. This shirt, also dibs. I loved this shirt, especially when I first got it. It was so bright and blue. With my tie-dye kit that I have, I'm gonna re-dye some of these shirts, I think. This shirt I love, and I still honestly should wear it out. I don't know why I don't. I think because it's not as colorful as it used to be. But like, honestly, I think I'm gonna start wearing that more. I just wear it to bed now, but it doesn't deserve that. It deserves to be worn. And then this shirt, which was my most anticipated one for this one, once again got worn the least because it's a fucking dress on me, and I'm decently tall. I'm like 5'7", 5'8". It's like a dress on me. It is massive. So this is a pajama shirt, and it wasn't as pink as I was wanting it. And I was really, really disappointed with this one. Like, very disappointed with that. But I like the other three, so I don't want to complain. The next line I guess we can look at is the Tanner Fox line. Yeah, I got the classic T-Fox shirt. I wore this in my Trampoline vs. Doggos video, which is such a millennial title. I was at Tara's friend Carmen's house. So pretty there. I will probably never go there again though, unfortunately. Hopefully I'll buy a house nice like that. I'm like, when I'm older. I have the classic white sweater as well. This really defined November 2020 and beyond. Like that time, I was obsessed with these Trox, if you remember. Yeah, I really liked these sweaters. It was really comfy, and just as time goes on, sweaters just get less comfortable, which kind of happened with these ones, but I really loved them. And then I also got it in black with some teal, which I really like this one as well. Yeah, I don't really wear these ones anymore because I've kind of, like, my upper body's gotten bigger because I've been working out. So they don't fit as good as they used to, but that's just on me. I guess the next line we'll look at will be Joshua Bassett, because there's only two things, which is this t-shirt, which I love. I just don't wear it. I don't know why I don't. Like, there's no reason for me not to. Like, this exact thing is on my wall right there. Actually, there is a reason that I'm thinking about it. I just, like, the concert was great. It was a really good concert, except I just didn't like his behavior after it. And like, not to be rude, because like, I'm kind of cool with him now. It's like, whatever. But I just don't like his whole like religious aspect, which is like, sounds really mean. Like, I don't hate religion. I just hate people that like try to push their religion on everybody else. And it's like, that's what they make their whole like personalities about, especially after they got famous for something else. It's like, okay, I don't like that at all. So I don't support that kind of stuff. That's why I stopped wearing it, because I'm like, if I don't like how he's doing that, then why would I sit here and just like wear his stuff and like promote him? So I just stopped doing it. Then there's this shirt, which I really like it. It's actually really nice. I'm not really a long sleeve girly, and I just tried to do something different with my fashion sense and never really committed to it. Like, I've worn it a couple times, and every time I wear it, it looks great. It's just, I'm not often picking for a long sleeve, because if I'm going for a long sleeve, it means it's cold. I'm going for a hoodie, and I'm not gonna wear a long sleeve when it's warm. So that's why I don't really reach for this one. And then there is one more in my closet, which I'm now forgetting, which I think every single person that went to these concerts has, the Bassett hoodie, which I love, and I do wear this one. I got it oversized, so it's nice and comfy and warm, and it's great. And I think that whole concert was a great experience. He grabbed the rose from my hand. Oh my god, like, that was me. Yeah, it was really good. It was a fun trip, so wouldn't change anything from it. So yeah, good memories attached to that sweater. Then there's this one, which you're gonna be like, what? There's nothing on it. How's that merch? The back. This one Emily got me for Christmas. It's Taylor Swift. It's Haunted, the song. So it says, can't go back, I'm haunted, dial, blah, blah. And I love it. It's so cool. because this is kind of merch that's so discreet you don't even know it's merch, because everyone, it's just a cool design, and unless you know Taylor Swift, you won't get the reference. So I have this one, this Eras shirt. I don't have anything updated with the Tortured Poets department yet, but there's this one. I love it. She's cute. I was gonna wear this to Taylor Swift night at the bar, and then I got sick, so I couldn't go. And then I have this shirt, which is the Lover one. I loved this collection. I think this was like the last collection that I really liked from her. I loved it. I loved the Lover shirt. I got it. This is the back of it. I still wear this one. I like to wear it on back days at the gym. I think it's a great summer shirt. So yeah, that's one that's always in the rotation. I think this is my favorite. The red one, because look at that. It's so cool. Oh my God, I love this one. And that's the back. Matt, remember when that was how many stops there was on the tour? I'm so upset because I didn't get tickets. I missed a shirt. This is another Joshua Bassett one. A complicated tour. The shirt I really like. Another one that's kind of like hidden. And I like how oversized it is. It's nice to wear to the gym. This weird brand, Unexpected. I love this shirt. I just want to unstitch the logo from it. Which is so mean. I love the funky design of it. And I think it could go really hard in some outfits. But the design, like the brand name on it, just kind of ruins it for me. So I don't wear it as often as I'd like. Also from them are my favorite pajama pants, and just pants because they're just so funny. They're they're two colored, and it says be yourself on it because you should be yourself, and I love them. My mom makes fun of me every single time I wear these out of the house. The one time I went to her work and her boss was like, oh my God, they actually exist. Like, she tells people about these pants, like, they're awesome. I love them. And then I think I really like a lot of the merch I got from them. And then I got this shirt. This is a Christmas shirt. It's a Christmas penis is what we call it, but I don't actually know what it is. It's just, it's Christmas themed, and I got it around like November, so it worked. And I like having some Christmas clothes because, like, I like getting in the spirit, so it makes it more fun. Then there is this shirt, sweater, which is like four different sweaters, like, sewn together. I wish I didn't get this one. I don't wear it. It doesn't fit me as nice as I'd want it to. It's like a little too tight on me. I'm like, I like my sweaters to be loose, so I don't wear it that often, even though it could be so cool. Like, just like that top part, like, that's so cool. Maybe if I was skilled at sewing, I would sew it into a blanket, but I'm not, so that won't be happening. The last thing from these guys is, I have some really nice pictures in this sweater. It's this one, it's a two colored, it's kind of giving gender reveal, but it's fine with the butterfly on it. I really like this one. I wore this to the pumpkin patch with Gracie and Tara in November or October of 2022. And I really like the pictures that I got in it, and just like I just like the outfit. And I think this sweater made it look really good. Here's a one-off one, Marvel. I don't know if this counts as merch. I got it at like a retail store, so I don't really know if that counts, but I'm putting it in here just cause it sort of is. Another one-off one is this shirt. It's Concert for Aliens. And you're gonna be like, what? That doesn't look like merch. Machine Gun Kelly, I got it off of Redbubble. I love the song and I'm like, yeah, I need a shirt for it because that was my face at the time. And I honestly barely wear this one. I probably could wear it more nowadays, but I just haven't really worn it. And then another shirt that I don't know if counts, but I just want to show it anyways, Bob Ross. It's my painting shirt. Yeah, it definitely does not count as merch, but I love Bob Ross, so that's why we're putting it in here. This shirt, which I love and I still wear, is my Johnny Orlando one. I adore him. Oh my God. So much. This is the back. It's got like the track list. I also love this album. I think it's a really strong debut album, so I like it. His concert was also amazing, which I made a video on, which did really well. Thank you very much, by the way. Another one. This shirt. It's Not Living If It's Not With You by the 1975. I saw this shirt on TikTok actually, and I was like, damn, I really like that. And I kept it in my saved. I'm like, okay, I'm not gonna buy it right away. If I still want it in a little bit, I'll buy it. And I kept looking back at it. I'm like, I want it, but I'll wait. I want it, but I'll wait. Finally pulled the trigger. Love it. I'm glad I got it. This one. I love this shirt. Oh my God, I have the hat too. I love this sweater. It's from Coop's Advice. Rest in peace, Cooper Noriega. I love this one. I love the message on it. It's so comfy. Do not regret getting it at all. I think this is one of my favorite items I've ever got because part of it went to charity. I don't know where the hat went, but I'll put a picture of me in it. Love it. And then we have some Jaden merch. I love him still to this day. You can't really see it though. There's that one. I think I like this one. This is more of a pajama shirt. I think it always really was. I had a really, really intense Jaden phase in 2020, 2021, 2022. I was really into him, and the only thing that got me out of my Jaden phase was Taylor Swift. And what got me out of Taylor Swift was the 1975. And yeah, it was complicated. I really liked him. I was obsessed with him. I would only listen to his music. I do have another shirt, but I don't know where that is. But I also have this sweater that says "Tell Me About Tomorrow." I love that album. It changed my life, I think. I also love this sweater. I wish I could wear it more, but I feel like it's a little bit too much, like, intense for me. Like, I just like dyed my hair like bright blonde. Like, I just feel like this is not my aesthetic anymore. At the time it was, like, my haircut and everything. It just really, the vibe I had, it worked until it didn't. Like, until I was like ready to get out of the phase that I was in. It was painful waiting for the haircut to grow out. So it worked at the time, and I do still listen to his music. I'm just like, this is just not my aesthetic anymore, but I'm keeping the sweater because it's comfy, and sometimes I do wear it, so. And then I also have this shirt, which is him flipping off the whatever. And then I also have the tour dates on the back. Yeah, I've never seen him. I should have seen him when he went to Toronto. I don't know why I didn't go. I didn't have anybody to go with, and I didn't have the balls enough to just buy a ticket for myself and go on my own, so I didn't go, which I regret to this day. And then I have this sweater, my Grey's Anatomy one. This was the sweater that I was wearing as I was getting out of that phase all the time. It was a rough phase in my life. You know, I made it out of it, and I love the show, and I still occasionally wear the sweater. Actually, I wear it pretty often. Yeah, I love that one. I got that one for Christmas from my dad, and it was a great gift because I didn't ask for it, and I got it. I'm like, oh my God, wow, this is amazing. We are at the very last item in our list here, our like group in our list. It's the Why Don't We collection. Getting this stuff was so difficult. Oh my God. It was like a pre-order, but it wasn't like obvious that it was a pre-order, and I waited like 6 months. I was like, I would not have bought these shirts if I was gonna wait this long, and I should have just got a refund low-key, but I didn't. So this is the first one I got, the Fallen shirt. I love this one, except for the Why Don't We at the bottom here. It just bothers me. I don't know why. It sits wrong on like in every outfit I put together with it, so I just kind of stopped wearing it, even though I probably could continue wearing it. I don't know why I don't. But now I feel like my arms would fill it out a little bit too much, and on certain days I don't like the feeling of it. Like, some days like I can like get by it, but I feel like most days I can't, so that sucks. And then we'll go to the least worn shirt out of all of these, the rose one. I don't know why I kept this one. It's got like the Why Don't We I don't know what it says, five on it, because there's five members. I think I wore this like twice. I don't know why I kept this one. Actually, this one fit me better than the other ones I got. I gave away some of them to Tagin. And then there's this shirt, which I also probably should have gotten rid of because I don't really wear it either, but I wear it to bed sometimes. I wore it up at the house, at Pablo and Hector's house the one time when I stayed there. Yeah, it's a nice shirt. I just don't wear it enough. I don't appreciate it enough. Like, somebody else could probably get a lot better of like wear out of it. There's this shirt, the band. I like this one. I do still wear this one to bed pretty frequently. And honestly, I've worn it to the gym a few times too. Yeah, I like that shirt. I think this one is my favorite out of all of them. It's the I don't belong in this club shirt. I love this one. I wear it all the time. Like when I would get called in to do dough, I'd wear this shirt. When I go to bed, I wear this shirt a lot. I wear it to the gym too. It's just like my go-to shirt. And then I have one more actually. And I don't know if it's in my room. I don't know where it is. So we're just gonna give up on that. It's just this picture from their album that they released on a white shirt. I really like that shirt as well. It's not worn as much as this one, but it's like the second most worn out of that collection that I have. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this video. It's pretty long. I have a lot of merch. So yeah, probably could have broken it up into two parts, but whatever. I don't like breaking up videos into multiple parts, so I like videos being one cohesive theme and being done, which is why my next video didn't come out sooner. So I was like, I don't want to do two parts for that. I want it to like have a finish. Like, I don't want it to be incomplete, which would be the same thing with this. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. I'm sorry about the long video, but you probably appreciate it because some of my videos are like 3 minutes long. So once again, thank you so much for all the support. And if you watched this long, thank you very much. It's much appreciated. But yeah, I will see you in the next video. Peace out. Bye, bitches.